This is the story of maths. At some point, humans started to spot patterns. To make connections, to count, and to order the world around them. People needed to count and measure.
Yeah, check it. One for Fibonacci, two for Hippasus, three for the fourth Hilbert problem of mathematics. It's five theorems, six corners, seven prime numbers, eight pre-dynastic studies of now floodings, nine Pythagoreans faithfully tracking the orbits with ten decimals, threaded numerical from the Babylonian degrees, sections conceptual, calculating seconds, minutes of arcs, six decimal, cuneiform carved testament to geometric views of Mesopotamian pre-Hellenistic intellectual fuel, reciprocal pairs, true place value system two in clay tablets, plinth and 322. Finding lines in rhyme, papyrus inscription, as the torch of math forces formed by Egyptians. Likely copied from the Middle Kingdom with arithmetic, primes, area, equations in pyramids. Mathematics then passes to the Academy of Athens as the Greeks speak Egyptian priests' beliefs in their own language with axioms. To get to a figure of depth, truth, the Hellenic mathematicians insist on the concept of proof. While Pythagoreans coined the very term mathematics, Thales is held as the first person to actually practice it. The Pythagoras cult believed in math with such passionate wonder that they drowned a member for discovering irrational numbers. Next came the Central Academy of Plato. Eudoxus brought us exhaustion, integration, and ratio. Plato himself discussed breathless lengths and foundations. Aristotle analyzed the significance of logical statements. In the Library of Alexandria, Euclid resided with the flame of enlightenment, but only half its writing survived it. Then Archimedes calculated the value of pi with preciseness and contributed to advanced mechanical devices. The golden age of the Greeks reaches its silver stage and eventually begins to scribble notation on its last pages. But other nations are faithful to mathematical continuations while Europe falls deep into the dark ages of mathematics.
Pure mathematics. Fractions. To push the subject forward. Explore the solar system without ever having to leave the surface of the Earth. Pure mathematics. Fractions. To push the subject forward. Explore the solar system without ever having to leave the surface of the Earth. To do mathematics, sometimes you just need to remove all distractions and to float off into a world of shapes and patterns. One, two, three, four, and this is how I do it.
Yeah, it's one universal law, but two sides to every symmetry. 300 BC, oldest surviving Chinese geometry. Forerunner rod system, probably used for notation. The 5th century, unprecedented pi calculation. Beyond the six figures to seven decimal characters. Eight pages, nine chapters of mathematical art on an abacus. 10 parameters as traders on travels reach the Indus Valley to see the translation of Sanskrit grammar in India. A singular philosophical inner property makes leaps and bounds in the invention of trigonometry, in engineering and astronomy. But what's clear though, is the extraordinary exploring of infinity and zero. And while Europe chokes under the yoke of the Catholic vision, new numbers had arisen called the Hindu-Arabic system, which coincided with the rise of Islamic scholastic tradition, exemplified by the work of the nascent House of Wisdom. Algorithms, reduction, balancing, transposition, parabolas, many of the contributions alongside algebra, decimal points, spheres, clear prototypes of calculus, calendars, parallels, frequency, and cryptanalysis. Islamic mathematics eventually fell stagnant around the 15th century, but finally reversing their backwardness, European scholars were sure that natural order and the plan of God can be found within numbers. And that's the moment when the travels bisect, as they seek out specific scientific Arabic texts. Steadily we witness the awakening of passion, as the key world theories are translated to Latin. All for mathematics.
Pure mathematics. Fractions. To push the subject forward. Explore the solar system without ever having to leave the surface of the Earth. Pure mathematics. Fractions. To push the subject forward. Many rank the Indian system of counting as one of the greatest intellectual innovations of all time, developing into the closest thing you could call a universal language. Mathematics. One, two, three, four. Well, here comes the really exciting.
Yeah, 1,000 years of silence before 1202, when Fibonacci finally showed Europe it could actually produce some new ideas beyond belief in three deities that had held it back intellectually since the 4th century. Eventually, it was economics and commerce that drove Renaissance algebra to calculate the dollars. Meanwhile, increased demand for navigation resurrected trigonometry for accurate map making. Then suddenly, the quicksilver from the granite had arisen. Galileo observed the movement of the planetary system, and while he succumbed to the Roman Inquisition, there was no stopping the inexorable on a roll of wisdom. Perspective flagellated Christ in the same art. The link of algebra and geometry is discovered by Descartes. Kepler, Fermat, Huygens with his time clicks. The battle of the calculus of Newton and Leibniz. Pascal, the Bernoullis, Leonard Euler with Payen. The equations of Gauss, the primes of Riemann. All the way to the year 1900, when Hilbert posed 23 unresolved problems. At this point in the action, we delve into abstractions, exploring infinity in Cantor's grid of fractions. Nevertheless, the task of all these intellectual passionates continues in the fundamental search for patterns. Using these universal numerical languages to devise solutions to problems with systematic analysis. And as we cling onto the spinning apple that the planet is, we can't help but feel awed at the mad dramatics of mathematics.
Pure mathematics. Fractions. To push the subject forward. Explore the solar system without ever having to leave the surface of the Earth. Pure mathematics. Fractions. To push the subject forward.
Poetry, with its rhyming structure and rhythmic patterns, resonates quite strongly with constructing a logical mathematical proof.